Hi, my name is Florian. I'm very proud to showcase you today our favorite thing that we have made the last couple of weeks. It's our data center in a box. What does it mean? So we have here two spine switches, four leaf switches, a data center gateway, and some servers running our data center applications, running in the data center. So the first thing what we want to do here is like why we have done this. So we want to operate a data center, obviously. If you want to operate a data center, you're probably relying on open source software. And what you may see on those two screens, and if you ever used something from the open source software space, then probably one thing what it was probably Grafana. So we have a very nice Grafana dashboard that's showing our topology, that's just replicating what we have here in the box, the two spines and the four leaves, and some clients running the traffic via our fabric. And you see this Grafana dashboard is quite feature-rich. We are showing here a lot of different values, right? We're showcasing the fabric health, we're showcasing the interface states, the interface rates, and much more that we can show here in the Grafana dashboard. The question is why we can do that. We can do that because all of our equipment has 100% young capabilities. That means we can live stream everything. It's a single fan, an interface, a rate, basically everything which is available as a config path, we can live stream to everything. And we do that with our automation platform called EDA. EDA is an event-driven automation platform that helps us to seamlessly operate data center equipment in your data center. If you've ever seen have EDA, this is our dashboard of EDA. So we see a lot of things in EDA that we can do. And we can operate, configure the fabric, and getting notifications, stuff like that. So far, that sounds okay and good. But what we want to do, we want to operate the data center, as I said. And let's go to the following scenario. You know that maybe. You have a problem in your data center or in your connections, and now you need to send a network engineer out to the field and doing a change on the boxes. So when we already know what the fabric configuration should look like because we call it an intent. So we know how the configuration should look like. So when now a network engineer going to the field and does changes, we call this a deviation. So let's play network engineer. We have here a control panel that just helps us and simulates that we are doing changes on the network device. So we will here just shutting down an interface. And you will see what happens. So we are on leaf one, E125, and let's shut down the interface. We shut down the interface, we will send it a JSON RPC request. And if you now go into the port, you directly see the link between those two guys are now shut down and blinking. Okay, but now, no, usually you're not standing in front of your rack. Yeah, you want to observe it from somewhere remote. So there you have multiple ways to do that. One way would be looking at your Grafana dashboard. You'd immediately see that the port from the spine one and the leaf one now completely is down. There's no traffic anymore, and the traffic was rerouted from spine two to leaf one. That's one thing, one indicator on the Grafana dashboard, but we also see now, oh, we have a problem with our fabric health. Something is not okay. And we have a problem with our node health. So leaf one is impacted, obviously, because we shut down the port here. But spine one is also impacted. So we see also here that we have an impact. But what happens if you're not having the constant view on a dashboard because you're not 24 hours per day watching at the Grafana dashboard? You may want to get notified. So you may use also very different messengers in your company, like you may use Telegram or Signal, Microsoft Teams, or as we do a lot, we're using Discord. Then you're getting your notifications directly in your favorite notification program, and you're getting notified that your interfaces are down, and then you can do reactions based on that. So I said we call this a deviation because we know how that should look like, and we should be able to react on deviations, right? So let's have a look back on EDA again. In EDA, we can go to deviations. You also get notified by the deviation, and we directly see there's a deviation on leaf one. Let's look inside what's going on. So we see on the right, you see also on the left, but I like to view on the right. We have an intended value of this port that should be enabled, but the running value is disabled. Obviously, that's a simple scenario, but it's directly showcasing what we want to see, right? So we have two options. We have two options. We can either directly accept it or we can reject it. Obviously, in our case, we want to reject it. And here again, we can directly reject it or we can add it to a transaction. And transactions in EDA is a very nice thing because you will directly understand what I mean by that if you're going further. So I added it. And now in our shopping cart, we see we have one transaction and you see a commit message. That should remind you on Git, because that is what it is. We can do commit messages, we can go backwards to any time when we want. And what we also can do, which is really nice, before we do something, we want to do a try run, right? If I'm clicking here, we will see in a matter of seconds, the commit is in progress. It calculates the full configuration for all impacted nodes. And now we can show something more, right? About the transaction summary, what it's impacting, could be a lot, right? But in this case, we are interested in the configuration of this node. We see here a div that you may have seen before with Git, right? On the left, we see its admin state disabled. That will go away. And we will add an admin state enable. That sounds good. Now, as a network engineer, I have made my decision. I want to accept that. So let's commit this. And it's committed. Having our Discord open, we're directly getting the messages that the interfaces are up again. Now it's a good moment to look at the Grafana dashboard again, because now we see the port is up again, and it's just a matter of seconds until BGP reestablished and the traffic will flow again, load balance on leaf one and leaf two. And now our fabric is fully healthy again. The traffic runs very flawless, and now we are back in a healthy state. Okay, but talking about a free and open source software, obviously if you're running IP equipment, you may have a Grafana dashboard, but there's another favorite tool that our customers are using a lot, and it's NetBox. I guess there are many people already have seen NetBox, but let's have a look at NetBox, how that looks like. So as you may have seen NetBox, NetBox has a lot of things you can do in NetBox. You can manage your devices and all of that. Not so long time ago, we added NetBox as an app to EDA. For now, we are focusing on the prefixes. This is what we manage right now because we want to consume IP addresses from NetBox, and we want to also report back to NetBox which IP addresses we are using, because in our opinion, NetBox is not only something like for configuration, it's also documentation and reporting. That's a quite important thing for us. And that's why we're focusing on prefixes and how we're using that, right? So what you may see here in NetBox, we see here we have actually two prefixes set. So we have one prefix set for the EDA system IPs, and we have a prefix set for the inter-switch links. So now it's fine that we have that and they are used in our fabric. We see there's some utilization, but let's say what happens if you need to do a change. So let's do a change. Let's just change the IP addresses from 14 to 13 and let's click save. That will take a matter of seconds, but let's see what happens in EDA. So let's go to EDA. In EDA, let's have a look on the IP addresses. So we just changed the system IPs, right? And now we see that we had previously 14, now we have 13. And this is now in use, and it's used in our fabric for the system IPs. And as I said, it's nice to have those changes in EDA, but actually, if NetBox is your documentation system, you want to see which IP addresses are consumed by EDA, right? Let's go back to NetBox. We just changed it, right? So if you're now having a look at IP addresses, we directly see those IP addresses are either managed and are used by the leaves and the spines for the system IPs, and we see now that we are now using the /13 subnet for these IP addresses. This is how you can operate your data center equipment managed by IDA and a bunch of open source tools that hopefully makes your life way easier to operate and your business more stable and reliable to your customers. And we can do that because we have IDA, we are relying on open source software, and we have very great hardware that we use and try to offer to you. And we really love what we're doing here. So we hope you do too. And yeah, thank you very much.